doing the wrong one. Got that one. Ah, press the wrong button. There we go, it's me. I haven't got a background. Let's fix that, shall we? I've got another a wide selection of backgrounds now. So, yep, this is apparently normal, so Fringe Styling tells me. So let me just put a background on. We'll go for the 319. And we will save that, and we will cancel. And scenario has started. Track IR is not working. Ah! It was working earlier on. Oh, track IR. Anyway, we'll do track IR. Good afternoon, driver. It's stormy, but you should be all right on your trip to London. First let passengers on board here at Shenfield. It's that one. I need that one. What headlights have we got going on here? AWS alarm. That'll do. Right, so welcome to the show. Tungsten Ring says I'm going to spat at least six times. I think saying at least six times, really, it's like saying at least once. And that's like, you know, that's the easy way out. So, what have we got on there? Who have we got on the chat? We've got lots of people on the chat, which is cool. This scenario is Stormy Trip to London by Fringe Stalin. If you play it, then when it pops up at the beginning with an error, just use the F2 trick to carry on anyway. Right, next station is Brentford. One brakes, come off. I'm on brakes. Oh, I've got no pantographs left.
Duh.
Now it might go. Hey! Dear, oh dear, that's a really outstanding start to the day. Anyway, so it's all going to be a bit weird, so I'm not going to be able to hear an awful lot out of the game today because something's gone wrong with these headphones, and I can only hear out of this ear, and it's not very loud. Well, I can hear the horn, so that's a good sign. Right. So this is one of Fringe Starling's busy, high-tensiness scenarios. Oh dear, oh dear. Let me move that a bit further over to here. So how is everyone this evening? Sign of things to go on. Starting to fail. There we go, everyone's just overflowing with confidence. That was nice. 90. So this is on the Great Eastern Main Line. Driving the Class 360. We'll have a look outside in just a minute. Tungsten, I've tried that. I've done all sorts of unplug it, plug it in, and re-plug it, and do all sorts of different things, and it's not really helping. So I think I just need to wait till next month and buy another set of headphones. This wasn't a particularly expensive pair, so I'm not that bothered particularly. It's just inconvenient for right now. Right, let's get stopped. Good. Right, apologies, I'm not really looking at the chat. Oh, what else have we got going on here? Could you please use the F3 HUD? That's an excellent point. And look up a bit more. Right, how about that? Is that going to be better if I sit back a little bit rather than constantly leaning forward? TK, why not use the headphones that come with the phone? Because they don't think they have the microphone that will do any good. I guess I could use a separate microphone, but I'm kind of used to my headphones. Can everyone else hear the audio okay? Is everything actually good? Ridecar, no, track IR isn't working. It was working, but I shut the game down, restarted it, and it seems to have got confused somewhere along that way. Right. Next stop is Harold Wood in 3.2 miles. So Brentwood to Harold Wood means we are heading to London. And funnily enough, this scenario is called Stormy Trip to London. Mal, I'll have a look at your... What was your question, Mal? Yes, couple up, are all of the AI traffic you place in a scenario is there and doing stuff all the time. Yeah, I know I missed a screenshot opportunity there for it to start with. Never mind. I was looking at the chat. Right, how are we doing time-wise? Doing alright, green lights so far. This slight excessive speed is helping me to... Right, that's probably confused you, hasn't it? Ah, that's not too bad. So far we're edging up on the time frame to get into Harold Wood. We're about 7 seconds ahead of schedule at the moment. How is that? How bad is that? Right, another screenshot and then I'll stop messing about. Right. We're actually about 20 seconds ahead of time now, that's looking good. Yeah, it's always raining in the UK. Ridecar, is Matt being a tart again? Speed limit warning dropping back to 60. We've actually earned ourselves a bit of time now, so we can afford to take it a little bit easy. I need a light meter. Ah, oh, we should make sure we add a light meter into the next game, shouldn't we? And the grid. You know the grid that cameras have? We need to make sure we add that. Coplopper says I'm losing a race. I didn't know I was in a race. Right, so way ahead of schedule. Open the door, have a look. Crap, there's AI that will pass at some of these stations. Nothing there. Nothing here. Ride car says, no need for thirds grid, do it by IU Cheetah McCheeterson. Well, you know what? I am Cheetah McCheeterson. Why would I therefore not want cheaty cheaty stuff? Not way ahead, a few seconds. Hit the big red button, says Henry. What big red button? I didn't know I had to hit the big red button. I'm confused now! Yeah, so this scenario is Stormy Trip to London by Fringe Starling. It's on Steam Workshop. Just a quick note, when it starts, it comes up with a warning of an error about two services that are blocked. Just press F2 and cancel and get on with the scenario. Anyway, it seems to work beautifully. Well, hello. No, that's a bit too close. What, eh? No. That's more like it. That'll do. Oh, shush. Okay, next station is Gidea Park. Still getting beeps. Yep. Oh, I bet I know what's happened. Yeah, because I wasn't watching it, the thing went off. Now we're good to go. Because I wasn't in the cab, the alarm went off and put it into reverse. Put it into emergency brake, so... got yellow, a green light again. Oops. Overspeedious again. The 360 coming in that general direction. Come back down to the 50 limit. Who told him about the pause button, says Levi. Everyone's getting, he's taking screenshots again. Can we get back to driving? Metro Ralph Ram, press the pause button. I'll give you a demo if you want. Everyone loves it when I press the pause brake key. Yeah, actually, this is not charisma, so as Ed just points out, which means I can go as fast as I like. And there's no penalty, other than falling off the track. That's probably a bad sign. My mic audio could do a turning up if you... Yeah, my headphones are a bit on the wonky side, so... Ooh, this could be an interesting stop, or lack thereof. Oh, excellent! Oh, look at that! Look at that! I'm not sure why the microphone is quiet. It's coming through the normal speed. I've just adjusted it a little bit. Maybe that's better. Let me know if that's better. KevMC says pause doesn't stop the train. You must be pressing the wrong pause button. I could turn the audio of the game up. How? I mean, I could definitely turn the audio of the game up. There you go. Next station is Romford. Oops. All the doors closed. They're all closed. Right, let's get out of here. No, CID, I'll restart the game after this. Can you move the camera up? I'm confused. Oh, hello. Is this some growler action? OMG, stop pausing the game. Getting screenshots. Steve's typing to me on Skype. That's all of that Skype noises. I think he's trying to put me off. That's the warning for the 60 coming up after Romford. Due into Romford any second now. Look at that. Oh, what's going on the chat while I've been sitting here concentrating? Right. It says, right, Steve, if you go around Matt's house, please, please, please destroy the pause key. Chadwell Heath. Are we shut yet? We're shut. Right. I say, I must admit, this isn't particularly stressful so far. The timings are tight, but I wouldn't call them stressful. Next station, Chadwell Heath. Almost up to the 70, so I won't even have to just leave it on full power. Chadwell. I have no idea, Joe. ...1.7 miles though to get there, wherever, however you want to pronounce it. Running just about bang on time at the moment, which is good. I will avoid taking a screenshot. I know how it's upsetting everybody when I take screenshots. There you go, I've just passed by a really good opportunity for a screenshot, and I feel a little bit sad about that, if I'm honest. King of addiction to taking screenshots, this is a problem. Hey there, AC6000. Fringe, you can't tell me in one breath stop taking screenshots and the other breath saying you should play it and get screenshots. I am going to come back, cut back on my screenshots since I'm apparently upsetting people. Oh dear. Open those doors! Screenshot simulator confirmed. Oh yes. The PZB special. Including route building under PZB and a long PZB scenario. You first then, mate, you first. Quite a nice rainy feel to this one, it's quite nice. You know, screenshots but no pausing. Well, previously people kept complaining, oh, you can get better screenshots if you pause. And they didn't realise what they were letting themselves in for, apparently. Cheers, Joe. See you later. Good maze! The doors are closed, doors are closed. Time to get out of here. I got overtaken by a class 90. I don't think I need to feel bad about that. Callum, yes, this is a workshop scenario. This is a stormy trip to London by Fridge Starling on the Great Eastern Main Line, the GEML. The Matt Pedalston simulator. That would be impossible. Computers don't exist that have the processing power to simulate Matt Pedalston, trust me. It would only ever be half a job. All graphics, you see. Oh, we're about 30 seconds ahead of schedule now. Right, car, I'm applying maximum power because I was told this is a high stress scenario where I needed to gun it, and that's exactly what I'm doing. Oh, I see what you're doing. Yeah, okay. 10 apply, 20 ignore PZB, 30 go to 10. Very good, ride car. That's some nice basic programming there. You forgot ignore speed limit, ignore signals. Van Leero, I'm sorry, I haven't really been paying attention to the issue. I thought, yeah, I think he's talking to Steve about it. So, whatever Steve says, I'm sure Steve will know the best. Fringe Starling, the AI on this scenario is intense. There's a heck of a lot more AI on than there really is on the line, I think. But I like it. Irish Michael's getting hypnotised by the wiper. So So something I've been thinking about, and it's not going to be for a while, but I just wanted to get everyone thinking as well, is I'm thinking about maybe in the future doing a 24-hour stream. Thinking about maybe doing it on, say, a Saturday, starting from something like 9 o'clock in the morning and then running through to the following 9 o'clock in the morning, and then doing the whole thing for charity. What thinks ye, folks? What thinks ye? Apart from me apparently being completely and utterly mad. You're getting very sleepy, yeah. Make the 24-hour stream of PZB special. Yeah, those donations would need to be pretty substantial, I tell you. Seven Kings! Yeah, just basically for the stream, it'd just be London-Brighton. Just going Brighton to London to Brighton to London to Brighton. No, I haven't decided what I'm going to do yet. I certainly haven't decided when I'm going to do it, and it's not going to be anytime soon. Oh, that's nice. That's nice. So, I just thought I wanted to get feedback. See what people think. I mean, I thought it'd be a good chance to do some long scenarios. Maybe we could do one of the 6-hour Donner Pass scenarios. Then do some high speed ones. Maybe do some route building. Maybe do some two or three scenarios. French style in that 90 going past. Very nicely done. London King's Cross to Peterborough in a class 03. I was hoping it would be interesting, not just an episode, 24 hours of epic pain. Pump car, 24 hours. Next station is Ilford. Oh, the door's shut. The doors are shut. Alright, well, if everyone thinks it's a good idea, then I will put some more thought into it. Cheers, Van Lero, thanks for joining. Ilford is next. Ah, that's warning. We've got a 20 limit coming up for the changeover. Right. The next stop is Ilfred, says Metro. Right, that's that one. Well, Dave, I think the thing is, one of the things I'm interested in is finding out what the moderators will be able to do, but obviously without a date, then it's a bit difficult to pin anything down on, see what people can do. So, we'll find out. But if everyone's up for it, then it's worth looking at, isn't it? So, Leave it with me, folks. It won't be for a while. Yeah, moderators will have to do shifts. Might have to see if we can get some more moderators roped in. Due to high winds, Network Rail have imposed a 20 mph speed limit on the flyover. Good, we're all doors closed. Oh, the 20 started a bit early. So we're on the flyover now. Nice one, Dave. Well, I was expecting the 20 to be where it said 20. I guess it did say on the flyover, so I had all the warning I probably should have needed. Hey, Dandy S24, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Another 90 down there. Crikey, there's a lot of 90s out today. Awesome. Next station is Manor Park. Ed, I have no idea what charity it would be for yet. Oh, now we're out of the 20. Again, at the moment it's more a concept than a well thought out plan. There's lots of stuff would need to get put in place. Like taking days off work to recover. Right, that's Manor Park. Just catching up on the chat, see what's going on the chat. Next station is Forest Gate. Right, next station Forest Gate in just under a mile. That was Manor Park, so Forest Gate, Maryland, Stratford and then Liverpool Street. Simulation error, if your train does not move, blame evil cyborg widgets. I completely. Thank you. Everyone's being mean to me again on the street. Oh, is this a Duff? Yeah, it's a 47. Oh, hello. 60 mile an hour at this close to a station. This could be tight. Nah. Alright, that was boring. It wasn't that tight. Due in at 34, coming in 30 seconds early. Yeah, you're off your game on this one, Fringe Starling. This one is, all the timings are about 20 seconds late. Later than they should be, to be, you know, tense. It's a fun scenario. I love the AI. Remember review at the end. Yeah, it's where, where I've been sitting here saying, oh, it's really easy, and then at the end I've got crosses on half the stops. So I look. Hey, ticks. Hey, hundreds of spads. Hundreds of overspeeds. CAD, I can make the case cam bigger, but it's not a quick job because I've got all of the cabs to resize and I've got loads of them now. Oh, another 90. So, that's tricky. Don't do what you did and forget to open the doors at Maryland. Nearly Stratford and Nebworth rolled into one. Well, Forest Gate and Nebworth rolled into one. I haven't missed Stratford yet. I've got every possibility of missing Stratford yet. Another 360. The only thing I would say is I have a sneaky suspicion, and I might be wrong here. Am I wrong here? Yeah, I am wrong here. This is the correct line. For some reason, I thought we were on the wrong pair of lines, and no, this is the right pair of lines for the. Because Forest Gate is where I used to get on the train to go to work, and this is exactly what I used to do, so. I'll look at resizing it a little bit, but it'll be for the next stream rather than when I come back after resizing the game. I can maybe look for doing that tomorrow. It is a bit on the small side, I noticed that today. It's because I resized the game up to 1920x1080, and the camera stayed at about the same resolution, so it consequently got smaller. Now we're going to be late. Hey there, King Samuel. My bus used to go right past Maryland to get to Forest Gate. How weird was that? Darkness Monster, but Matt, for the 24 hour live stream event, did you have any idea on when to do it, like in what month? No. I haven't even got that far. Not anytime soon is what I would think there. Not anytime soon, because it needs a lot of planning for a 24 hour stream. So I want to try and get the planning underway. Right, next station is Stratford. It's a case of the, if we get it thought about now, then we can, then we'll be in a good position to actually go ahead and, to do it later on. Copper up a mile. So my workspace is 1920x1080, and it streams it, but when it outputs the stream, it shrinks it down to 1280x720. So the camera is being rendered on a 1920x1080 space. Trust me, I had to resize everything on OBS when I did that. Because everything all of a sudden was in the middle of the screen. The workspace has gone up to 1920x1080. And then it crunches the resolution down on the way out of OBS up to Twitch. Welcome to Stratford International. Well, Stratford anyway. Over there we have the Stratford eyesore. Change here for connections to the London Underground. National and international services. Well, you won't get any international service because they don't stop here and never will. Right, next station is... Dark, no, it'll be this year. What I want to try and aim for doing them is, at a minimum, I want to do them for Children in Need and Comic Relief. So that's November and March, I think, February, March. And possibly one sooner than that, as a trial run. So, sometime over the summer, maybe. Didn't get to the speed limit quite as fast as I thought I would. Yeah, sometime over the summer. Because it's easier to stay awake in the summer months. Hey there, Steeler Boy. Good evening, and thank you for joining. Hey there, CSX boy, welcome to yourself as well. This is the DLR lines over here. That would be Pease Pottage or something like that. Oops, now we're speeding. Stop speeding, you naughty boy. Metro, the Friday's possible, but I wanted to make it, I thought maybe a Saturday would be more people could join in. Could book the Friday off as well, do it on a Friday, it's another possibility. That's the reason for mentioning it, to be honest. Find out what people can do, what their thoughts are. Because, to be honest, if no one can turn up to it on that particular day, there's no point doing it. We're having guest drivers. I don't know. We'll have to work out the logistics of that. Yeah, I mean, I'm thinking Saturday would be better for most people. I'm wondering, actually, maybe what we do is we get... Mole Man and Steve to actually come round here, and then they can take a section of driving as well. Team effort. That might be the way to do it. I'm driving really slow now because I'm not really paying attention. Warning for the 40. Warning for the 30. That's an interesting idea, Coplopper. Something to think about. A novel idea, Kirkenstein. I could get Cameron to do some driving. That would be interesting. This is where, after this really interesting, relatively lightweight run, I get hit with a red light at the end of the scenario. They're still coming in, we're due 2 seconds late, so I'm happy with that. Phil offers a root build, awesome. We've got some potential there. We need to work out the logistics then and work out what will actually work and what won't work. Maybe keep it technically simple for the first one and then try broadening things out. But yeah, that's cool. I'm quite invigorated by that. It sounds like we can make that work, I think. Through work as well, make sure that there's no objections there. I'm sure there won't be, but it's best to get these things squared away. God, it looks like this is going to one of the platforms I used to go when I arrived at work. One of the far left platforms. Oh yeah, you're right, I can turn the wipers off now. Tune at 14:46. We're a minute early. I think we could get guests on. I think one of the things that might work reasonably well, I need to try it, is to get people on just via Skype to talk to, you know, while maybe I'm sitting here driving and maybe someone else can be, we can be talking via Skype on the stream. I think that would give people different things to listen to rather than just me droning on for 24 hours. Oh, I can't think of anything worse. The number of times I have stood just there, waiting for trains to arrive, is insane. Nathan Rutter, no, this is the first scenario of the night. We've got more, loads more to go yet. Where's the throttle sticks? That'll be that one there. There you go, Matt early in a fringe scenario. I can only assume fringe kind of dropped the ball on this one. Still not up to the buffers. Ed's completely upset about that. Which means I should just top that off by just using the pause button. Get back on the platform, sir. Right, well done, you completed all tasks today and on time. Now you can take a well-earned rest. Yes. Speeding 7 times. There was nothing major there. Awesome. Right. That was the first scenario of this evening. Phew. Master Daniel said,